So let me set the stage. It's 2003, All-Star Game. It's in Atlanta.
Atlanta.
Tell me.
So 2003 in Atlanta, MJ's last All-Star Game. And it was,
Janae and I were on our way to grade school.
The NBA, if you would, kind of encourage, hey, it's probably a good idea that MJ starts in his last game. That was a no-brainer for me, but, you know, you go through all the protocols. And I remember walking in All-Star, you know, all of the festivities, you know how All-Star Weekend is. This is bananas, and MJ's in the back doing what MJ does with Ahmad and all those guys. And I walk in and I said, hey, MJ, you know, it's your last All-Star game and everything. You're going to start. He said, no, you earned it. I said, no, you don't hear me. You're going to start, because I didn't want to get blackballed. I didn't want the NBA in the world. Like, how did you take MJ's spot? Yeah, how is he not starting his last All-Star game? Yeah. So he's like, no, you earned it. Go ahead. So I go back in, get dressed, and I'm like, man, there's no way. So I go shooting right here. That conversation right there is where I'm telling him. And he's telling me, he's like, you earned it. I said, you're going to do it. So I said, MJ, look here. I am going to walk into the back of the locker room during starting lineups, because I'm not, you're going to start. I'm not about to get blackballed. So I started walking in the back, and they call him out. Boom, he walks out, starting lineup, and everything good. Right here, you see patented MJ fadeaway over Sean Marion. I mean, if you notice right here, nothing but net. We tried our best. We're yelling to stop the game right there. It was like 7 seconds, I think. We're saying, stop the game.
Yep.
Well, rest in peace to Kobe Bryant. Being Kobe Bryant, he wanted to win the game, steal the show. So he gets the ball out of a timeout. He gets fouled by Jermaine O'Neal, hits both free throws, and we lose.
Oh my god!
We end up losing that game,
but it was
memorable. Just watching MJ for the last time in the All-Star game, and you know, I grew up watching MJ and shooting the fadeaway, and he hits it right there in that moment, All-Star game. We were like, NBA, this is it. This is how you close in error and in an unbelievable career from MJ. But
so that's MJ. What about Patrick Ewing?
Well, Pat Ewing is one of my guys, and if he's watching this, he's gonna be mad. Love you, Pat. But but you know, I as a young dunker, you know, I come in. You know, you have a dunk list. I had a dunk list, and there were just guys that I wanted to dunk on who I respected as great shot blockers.
I need a copy of this list, please.
Right, run it back, please.
I mean, we saw Olajuwon earlier, and obviously Patrick Ewing is one of the guys that I respected. And I mean, sorry once again for the green. It was a little older. This was a while ago, but. For some reason, you see my reaction here. It's like I was excited. So I typically, after a dunk or a highlight, I don't really go home and go watch SportsCenter. SportsCenter was around. Yeah, I don't really go home and watch SportsCenter
highlights. You're not that old, Vince. Come on now.
But I don't go and watch highlights like that. But for some reason, that night, I went home to watch that highlight that I dunked on Patrick Ewing. It was, I don't know. And you can see the excitement in that
dunk. He says for some reason, I wanted to go and get some popcorn and put my feet up. I would have done the same thing.
I was checking the box off.
It was just something like, yes, I dunked on Patrick Ewing. And that was some excitement in that dunk. You know, it was pretty cool.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.